Hi everyone. Thank you for being with us today. I'm Jiwon Kim, specialized on a project to improve the TV app development environment at Samsung. Today, I'm very excited to introduce you to a tremendous solution that can upgrade the Tizen TV app development environment to the next level. Let's get started. We, Samsung, are making every effort to improve the development environment for the Tizen TV app developers and are actively communicating with various partner developers and improving problems based on their voices. This solution is part of the effort. To give you a clear understanding of how it works, instead of simply listing the features that this solution has, I will try it in this way. I'm going to talk based on the developers' actual voices that we've listened so far. In other words, I will explain the limitation of the current TV app development environment through several typical situations that developers are experiencing. And then, let's see how we can overcome this with the solutions we present. Let's first look at the situations that developers are experiencing. These are commonly faced situations when developing service for consumer devices such as smartphone and TVs. First, app development process. If there is no actual sample for development, development is usually carried out using an emulator. However, the environment in which the emulator operates are different from the actual device based on hardware. Some APIs have limitations like unsupported or only operate based on dummy data like encrypted content playback or hardware profile-based APIs, such as device ID can be an example. Second, let's say that the service that we released in October 22 now causes problem with a particular TV from 2019. Do you have a development environment consisting of specific TV produced 3 years ago? For scaling the support TV, the first thing to do is to make sure that your service is working properly on the product you want to scale. Because the latest APIs that you used may unsupport it on last year's product or OS version. Checking software on different TV model is kind of prerequisite of service scaling. With new recent pandemic, work from home has become a natural type of work environment. You are already used to it, right? By the way, I would like to ask how many people have development environment in their homes? Of course, there can be various different situations other than that. But these four situations are most probable situations anyone can experience. And it's quite frustrating when you actually encounter them. I've experienced these situations when I was developing the service myself, so I can resonate them a lot. So now, let's take a look at what we need to overcome this situation. In the case of app development, software-based emulator has limitations in checking operation. So we need an actual device that can check all functions 100%. This will be the cost for purchasing the actual device, and each time a new TV is released, there will be additional cost. This can be obviously cost burden, even in the case of market issue and service scaling. The target TV is necessary. It could be the latest TV, and it could be the last year TV, and it could be a specific lineup, and it could be sold on a specific country. If the TV is not ready for these cases, support from headquarters will be needed. Of course, we can analyze and resolve the problem with the support from the headquarters, but it will need extra time to communicate. In the case of work from home, you will need a development TV that can be used outside the company. To sum up these situations, eventually, developers need TVs that are ready to use anytime, anywhere. Also, various TVs should be available as needed. Of course, if we have enough money to buy all these TVs and plenty of storage space, you can. And it must be so hard to move the TV you need every time. it doesn't seem easy. What should I do? Anytime, anywhere, any TVs. That means ready to use TV anytime, anywhere. This is the starting point and final goal of Rtl Tv. Rtl Tv stands for Remote Test Drive for TV. Already, Samsung developer site provides mobile device environment through the Remote Test Drive service. Now, we want to provide Rtl service to TV app developers as well. Basically, TVs are big and very inconvenient to move around. And in order to control the TV and check the screen directly, the TV must be located near the developer. How can I overcome this and become a ready-to-use TV anytime, anywhere? How about this? What if you could access and control the TV for development of your desired model over the internet? And if you can check the TV screen through a web browser without any special programs, you won't have to store a big TV, and you won't have to move every time you use it. Developers will be able to develop Tizen TV apps anytime, anywhere, with just one internet-connected PC. To meet these conditions, Rtl Tv provides a web browser-based service. No specific program installation is required. We also minimize the browser dependency. It works fine with most of the browser you use now. In short, now all you need to develop Tizen TV app is an internet-connected PC. This is the basic flow of the Rtl Tv. Users access the Rtl Tv site and select the TV they want to use. When users select the TV, the TV farm, which we built and ready to run, will immediately assign the TV of your choice to use. Then, users can do whatever they want with their assigned TV. This TV farm is located in Suwon headquarters. All the activities required for necessary maintenance to keep this farm, such as adding devices and updating firmware, are managed by Samsung. So, Rtl TV users don't have to worry about anything. However, if you have any problems or additional requirements during use, just let us know. To use Rtl TV, you must have an account on Samsung developer site, since the Rtl is located inside the Samsung developer site. First, access the Samsung developer site and log in. On the main page of the Samsung developer site, when you select the support menu at the top, additional menus are displayed, and select Remote Test Drive. Now, you have arrived at the main page of the Remote Test Drive. Select the Get Started button in the middle to go to the detail page of the Rtl. If you select a TV from the menu on the left, you can check which TVs are being currently served. As I said, no additional program is required. To give you a glimpse of how to use Rtl TV, let's have a look at the demo video. You will see clearly how Rtl TV actually works. This demo shows that connect TV and PC after accessing Rtl TV, running an app on Rtl TV. Device select here and select the period that you want. Now, device loading is started. Loading complete, and Rtl TV shows now. Let's connect TV and PC with SDB. Depending on the network situation, you can enter or skip the proxy. Open the sample app on VS Code. It is a simple app that just shows the welcome to Rtl TV. And let's try to launch the app on Rtl TV. Now, the app is launched on Rtl TV. Let's change something in VS Code. Change the word Rtl to real. And launch the app on Rtl TV again. previous app is closed, modified app is launched now. As you can see, the app simply launched on Rtl TV from PC. Now, let's take a closer look at the Rtl TV support environment. Rtl TV plans to support various devices such as TV, Settle, and smart monitor, and we'll continue to add support devices. Based on the Tizen version, we plan to support the TVs over 3.0 and beyond, and based on the year, 2017 TV, and representative models of the premium and basic lineups will be supported. For your convenience, it can be used in multiple browsers such as Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and Edge. Now let's look at the support feature of Rtl TV. TV and PC connectivity is essential for TV app development, which requires a smart debug bridge called SDB. Of course, Rtl TV supports SDB. This allows you to run and debug apps developed at your PC on Rtl TV. Remote control input is also supported, and it can be controlled through a keyboard or mouse to add convenience to control on PC. However, in case of mouse control, it can be only operated by an app that has been developed to operate the mouse. Rebooting the TV, which is one of the most necessary functions when developing the app. Real power on-off reboot is supported instead of software reboot. The Big Z function and the screen rotation function required by Settle model will also be supported as well. The features currently supported and the features targeted for support are not the end of what Rtl TV is aiming for. To maximize the capabilities that users need, we are continuously improving functions and usability through domestic and international field tests. Also, we are continuously listening to users' opinions. So, let's go back to the situations that we talked about earlier, where developers were struggling. Can Rtl TV solve all of these issues? In the case of app development process, previously, all the features supported by TV were not available when the real TV was not ready. However, if you use Rtl TV, you can start app development on real TV with full function available, from playback of various contents to login-based services. You can easily solve the issue that you had. In the past, if the TV that occurred the problem was not prepared, it was difficult to secure the TV. So we often analyzed the problem and found the solution through the support from the headquarters. But it may need more time for communication. Depending on the severity of the problem, delays in troubleshooting can lead to serious problems for service, such as reduced users. However, using Rtl TV, you don't have to get a real TV, and unnecessary support from the headquarters can be minimized, because you can access the TV that the problem occurred directly, check the problem, and proceed the correction process smoothly. If the TVs that you wanted to scale the service is not ready, it is difficult to check the behavior and further modification. Schedule for service scaling could be delayed. If the timing of service scaling is very important, it could be a problem with market share due to the rate scaling. It can also resolve the situation that access the desired TV through Rtl TV and prepare for service scaling. If there are restrictions on TV-related work due to the absence of TV while working from home, there will be a big problem in the productivity of work. This would be a situation that developers or companies never want to happen. Furthermore, it may not be easy to work from home in the future. If you use Rtl TV that can be used by just internet-connected PC, you don't have to worry about this, right? Every situation that we looked at today seems to be solved through Rtl TV. Of course, just because Rtl TV can respond to the situations presented here, it doesn't mean that Rtl TV is the perfect solution. But as long as developers have a powerful tool called TV can be used by just internet-connected PC, many of the situations that can occur in development environment due to the absence of TV will be mostly resolved. Rtl Tv is not the first prepared solution. During the last pandemic period, Samsung has already overcome the crisis by using Rtl Tv and confirmed the benefit of this solution. Even at this moment, many Samsung TV app developers are experiencing efficient software development through Rtl Tv. We want to share this innovative development experience with Samsung's TV app partners. The biggest advantage of using Rtl Tv is an efficient development environment. The cost of purchasing development samples can be minimized. And minimizing unnecessary support from the headquarters will be a tremendous time-wise efficiency. We have already completed the closed beta test with various partners in Korea. And now, we are conducting the closed beta test with several overseas partners. We are preparing for the official opening in the second half of 2023 by conducting field tests with Samsung Research Institute in major overseas subsidiaries. In the future, news about Rtl Tv service will be delivered to you through the Samsung Developers newsletter. Some features we plan to support may change, but we will prepare to provide users with the most convenient features. As I said before, Rtl Tv is not the perfect solution yet. It will be a solution that grows together based on active feedback from partners. We will try to provide Rtl Tv service to our partners in stages, but in a stable manner. Please look forward to it. Thanks for joining me today. See you next time.